Well, hey, astronomers have just spotted a new planet approximately 22.5 light years away from us. Now, if you zoom in closer, see? It already has a McDonald's. How do they do that? Well, no, that's not true. The most exciting thing about this new planet, it has three suns. And researchers say that it might be our best shot at encountering other life forms. So, are we going to meet our space neighbors anytime soon? Well, before I data dump on you all about this new planet, I have to mention the way it was found. All thanks to TESS. Well, no, not my girlfriend TESS from third grade. This TESS stands for the Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, a NASA mission that's been in search of planets orbiting the brightest stars of our galaxy since April 2018. Within its lifetime, the satellite is supposed to monitor 200,000 stars, looking for any exoplanets, from gas giants to small-sized rocky worlds. By the way, TESS, from third grade, how do you like me now? On bright side, pretty cool, huh? Well, I keep talking about exoplanets, but what exactly are they? Well, it's literally any planet situated outside of our solar system and orbiting its own star. Yep, it's that simple. Unfortunately, it's quite hard to spot exoplanets from Earth, because the brightness of their stars effectively hides the planets from sight. Then again, scientists have already discovered more than 4,000 exoplanets, and aren't going to stop. If you want to find an exoplanet of your own, look for the stars that seem wobbly. The chances are high that a planet circles this star and occasionally blocks its light. But back to TESS, the satellite. Astronomers hope that during the first 2 years of the satellite's operation, it'll come across 10,000 unknown worlds. So far, TESS has already located several planets, including the one with three suns. This new world has the catchy name of LTT-1445AB. All the stars you see in the sky of this planet are red dwarfs in the second half of their lives, but the planet orbits only one of the three. This star looks like a glowing red disk from the surface of LTT-14, etc. As for the other two, they're much further from the planet and seem tiny and dark. An unprepared observer would probably take them for two red, sinister eyes in the sky. Ooh, is that you, Saron? Analyzing the data received from TESS, the satellite, astronomers concluded that the newly discovered world is boiling hot on the surface, with temperatures rising as high as 320 degrees Fahrenheit. So, if you ever decide to visit this planet, you'd probably want to avoid trying to get a tan. Also, the planet is rocky, really rocky, more than 8 times the mass of Earth, and a third bigger than our home planet. Oh, and it orbits its parent star much faster than Earth goes around the Sun. It makes one full circle every 5 days. I should also mention here that TESS from third grade was also really hot. Back to our story. What excited researchers the most is the fact that Rocky seems to have an atmosphere, and that means that somewhere over there, there may be extraterrestrial life. What's more, the chances are high that soon, scientists will be able to confirm the existence of the atmosphere on the planet. Rocky is located relatively close to our planet, just 22.5 light years away, which is literally next door in space terms. And since the planet in question passes between Earth and its stars, astronomers can catch a glimpse of the gases that might surround the planet with the help of the telescopes based on Earth. Unfortunately, it's not possible to do right now. And even though TESS, the satellite, is great at discovering new planets, it can't say for sure whether E.T. and his friends live there. That's why, after making sure that Rocky, does have an atmosphere, scientists will have to send a deep space probe to the planet to investigate. And still, astronomers are full of hope. Although the temperature on the planet seems way too hot, there's still a chance that something or somebody has adapted to these nightmarish conditions. It's all good and well and very promising. But it got me wondering what our Earth would look like if there wasn't one but two suns in the sky. Remember the planet of Tatooine from the Star Wars movie? The one that was Luke Skywalker's home planet? In September 2011, astronomers discovered a world that eerily resembled Tatooine. The planet, dubbed Kepler-16b, consists of half rock and ice and half gas, and orbits two closely located stars. So, how about an experiment? Let's replace Kepler-16b with Earth and see how our planet fares, circling two suns at a time. First, the climate on the Tatooine-like planet is quite chilly, even though it's closer to its parent stars than Earth is to the Sun. However, there's no mystery here. Kepler-16b's stars are less bright than our Sun. That's why the temperature on the planet rarely rises higher than minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit. But under the same stellar conditions, Earth would be even frostier. Our planet would be freezing, because it would be situated farther away from the stars than Kepler-16b. That means that all the water on Earth would turn into ice, and it's unlikely that life would be able to develop in this glacial desert. Astronomers say that, in this case, the only living beings on Earth might be some advanced life forms that came from somewhere else and managed to keep themselves warm after relocating to our planet. Then, since Earth would be orbiting two stars, the year would become a bit longer. The thing is that the combined mass of the two stars Kepler-16b circles is 10% less than the mass of our Sun. As a result, Earth would move on its orbit more slowly, because the gravitational pull of the stars would be weaker. On the other hand, if Earth still had the Moon and its orbit was the same, the length of a day on the planet wouldn't differ from the one we have these days. Now, the two new parent stars of our planet would be about 7 million miles apart. That means they would orbit each other once every 10 days or so. Also, each of them would rotate in a 10-day period, which is a bit faster than the rotation speed of our Sun. Anyway, if there were people on the two suns' Earth, they would be able to observe a brand new, baffling phenomenon – an eclipse of the Sun caused by another Sun. The stars would pass in front of each other once every 5 days, and every time, the eclipse would last for about 6 hours. Interestingly, during the peak of the eclipse, our planet would get from 30 to 40% less energy than normal. That's why the days of the eclipse would be even chillier than the rest of the time on the planet. But the most amazing difference would be how the sky would look from the surface of the planet. The two suns wouldn't look very big, but they would be differently colored and so close together they would almost look like they were touching. And think of all those breathtaking sunsets! Astronomers are sure they would be different every single day. By the way, have you heard that we might already live in a solar system with two stars? Although this theory is far from being widely accepted, it may explain some oddities in the Earth's history, such as mass extinctions that happen too regularly for my liking. So here's the idea. Our Sun may have a companion, a theoretical white or brown dwarf star called Nemesis. Good name. This star can influence the orbits of celestial objects in the outer solar system and send them on a collision course with Earth, causing mass extinctions every now and then. For example, there were speculations that Nemesis could even affect the Oort cloud, a hypothetical region on the outskirts of the solar system filled with icy rocks. Rocky! Nemesis could probably kick some of these chunks out of their home cloud and send them hurling toward Earth. Wham bam! A new mass extinction. Well, right now, astronomers can't find any evidence that the dwarf star is accompanying our Sun somewhere up there. But according to a 2017 study, this star could exist in the very, very ancient past. Admittedly, the existence of this sun, Nemesis, would shed light – unintentional pun – on some large-scale planetary catastrophes. But don't forget that so far, it's just a theory. Hey, how about you? Do you have any other ideas on how several suns instead of one would change life on Earth? Maybe harder to throw shade at someone? Hey, let me know down in the comments. If you learned something new today, then give this video a like and share it with a friend. But hey, Tess from third grade, don't go anywhere just yet. We have over 2,000 cool videos for you to check out. All you have to do is pick the left or right video, click on it, and enjoy. Stay on the bright side of life.